Hey everybody, today is a Shahan's a cooking a class. Today we're going to do the red wine beef bolognese by Chef Plate. So join me, won't you? Alright, for the red wine beef bolognese, let's see what Chef Plate has given us in our bag. We got some lovely fresh basil. Okay, try not to get my shadow in the vase. We have a lovely yellow onion. Do that. Oh, look at this, they give you a carrot. Nice. Asiago cheese. That's good too. How about some seasoning, like oregano? That's very nice. We got a lovely tomato. This is a nice tomato. You know? Tomato. And we got some crushed tomatoes too. This is nice too. I'm gonna give you some fresh pappardelle pasta. Say that 5 times fast. Fresh pappardelle, fresh pappardelle. I can't do it. All right, red wine. We get some red wine. Okay, let's try. I'm going to do this. Here we go. So next thing we want to do is wash all the vegetables. So we have the carrot, we have the tomato, onion, not so necessary, and we have the fresh basil. But yeah, we're gonna just wash it now. Hang tight. Alright, let's clear some space here. What we want to do with the... we want to peel and small dice the carrot first. Okay, so I brought my peeler. Like this, like this, like this, and like this. We just peel. Don't get your finger in there. It's not so good. That was a close one. Okay. It's nice. Peeled. Okay. Now with all those table scraps, or not scraps, but scraps of vegetables, I take a bag, a Ziploc bag, put it all in there. What you do is you fill this bag here with all your vegetables, and later on you're gonna put it in boiling water and you're gonna create vegetable stock out of it. So you don't waste anything. I like it. Put that aside there. And then, oh, got some more here. Go in the scrap bag there. Take off the end. Take off this end. Into the bag. There you go. You want a small dice, so I think what I'm gonna do is put this down first. Half, split it here, and then we'll slice it. Into little bite-sized pieces. Okay. This one. Do this to the next one. Try not to get your fingers. It's not so nice. Make sure you use a nice sharp knife. I always sharpen the knife before. Okay. Get rid of that. I'm gonna put all this into a bowl. Oh, somebody heard the chopping of a carrots. And when you say carrots in my house, there is a little Miss Hoofy, otherwise known as Miss Cookie, who loves a carrot. So we're gonna give her a carrot. Okay. Cause, you know, she's good like that. So let's just find us a little itty bitty carrot and go, hey, you want a carrot? Okay, here. I'm gonna throw it on the floor. You'll get the carrot. Okay. All right, you just jump on that. There you go. Back to the program. All right. Okay. Next. What are we gonna do? and the knife. And oh, this is gonna make me cry. It's gonna make me cry. Why? Because I got a dicey yellow onion. I don't know about you, but it always makes me cry. Cut it in a half like that. And then we're gonna peel, right? So to peel, we're gonna do this. And into the bag it goes. Peel. Okay. In the bag. That's nice, eh? It's very nice. Nice onion. Okay, we gotta peel this one. It's half. Not crying yet. Tell me, I'm not gonna cry. It's not Oprah, you know. I'm not gonna cry. Not right now. Here we go. Little dice. So this is what we do. Do the dice. Keep the root on. I learned this from Gordon Ramsay. And then we do this at a 45 degree. Like that. And then we do the dice. Huh? Use your knuckle to guide you so you don't take out any fingers. That's a nice dice. Like that. And take this root into the bag it goes. Okay. Let's do this to the next one. Still not crying. Do it fast enough. Don't cry. No, we don't cry, eh? Cookie, we don't cry. No crying. Cookie's still waiting. She can't have onions. Onions not good for dogs, eh? So let's chop, chop. She's my sous chef, Miss Cookie. Okay. Now we get another bowl. Put all this in. Get rid of that. This guy here. Meanwhile, we got a pot of water, medium pot, with the salt in it, boiling. Waiting for it to boil. Still not boiling. Got some time. If you got the time, I got the oregano. Uh-oh, I hear another dog coming. Sounds like it's coming down. Oh boy. Okay, that is done. Now we got the tomato. We're gonna dice this guy too. All right, so. Half. Do it like this. Gonna do the same thing. Oh, I'm crying now. I gotta take this away here before I cry. Okay, I'm back. Said I wasn't gonna cry, but who knows? These things happen. Oh, this does not look so good. There goes my dicing. Maybe it'll work. Big chunky dice, tomato, cookie. I know what you want. I need a good chop. There we go, one-handed chop. Okay. There we go. There you go. Like that. Like that. All the goodness. My goodness. Then we go back to this one. A little thicker. Two cuts this way. And then we go with the knife. Do all the work. And Okay. There we go. Okay. So we got these done. Next, we want to pick the basil leaves. Get a little ramekin dish for that. Okay. Let's see. Hey, basil. Oh, some basil not so good, some okay. So we just pick. Oh, it smells so good. Put that back in there. Pick at the leaves. Pick at the leaves. Pick at the leaves. Pick all the nice leaves. There. Some a little bruised. I don't like that one. I don't like that one. It's okay. It's gonna cook it down. Okay, next, in the large pot, we're gonna add a tablespoon of cooking oil over medium heat, and then we're gonna add the ground beef. I'm gonna go get that. Okay, so I added some avocado oil because it has a nice high heat cookie. We'll talk later, okay? We got this to do first. So we're gonna do that, let it heat up a little bit. And this is the avocado oil. It's pretty good. Yeah, like I said, we'll discuss it later. Okay, so we got the ground beef going. Chopping it up, letting it cook it down. And then, on a medium heat. It's good, no? It's starting to taste the ground. And then we got cookies. We still want carrots. We love the carrots. Gotta wait. I'm sure you have the pan going. Alright, let it cook down. Alright, we also have some garlic. Now they provide it already peeled, which is nice. And with the garlic, we just want to mince it. Now we could use them. Garlic press, or we could just chop it. I do little slices like this. Okay. Oh, cookie. You like the garlic? It's not good for you. Okay, next one. I could have just used a garlic press, but I like it a little chunky. There you go, look at that, eh? Now, from there,
add a little ramekin.
There we go. Put it in here, like that. It's very nice. I love the garlic. And you know, what is the pasta without the garlic, right? Okay. Okay, so now we're gonna put the garlic. Need a little one of these. Garlic goes in. The carrots. And the onions. Just gonna do this. Spatula. I love these little guys. So good, eh? and then we're gonna go over here. Roll things around, roll things apart, brown the beef. Smell it, it's starting to get there, eh? Coming together. Break apart the ground beef. I want to be broken apart. But... let that cook down for about 5 minutes. Setting the time. Okay, 5 minutes. Ah, another thing we want to do is that'd be a red one. Chef's plate, they give you everything. They give you the seasoning. Everything. Gotta love it. There we go. Give it a little stir. Let that cook for about 5 minutes. Put everything down. Okay everyone, now we added the red wine. This is going to add a little acidity to it and give, make it nice and full body. Oh, we like when we're adding up the red wine, right? Red wine. That's nice, okay, to use some red wine. Let it cook down for about a minute. Alright, we'll just put a timer on that for 1 minute. Okay, like so. Okay, come back to you. Alright, now we're gonna add the tomatoes. Yeah. Stir it up. Oh, it smells so good with the red wine. Oh, it smells good. Smell that. Lovely. And then we're gonna add the crushed tomatoes. Oh, yeah. Get all that goodness in there. Come on. Get in there. Crushed tomatoes. Let me show you what it looks like. It's good, eh? Doesn't matter what you do. Put that to a medium heat and we're going to cover it. Give it 5 minutes. We're going to let it sit for 5 minutes. And we're going to go over here and add the pappardelle. Okay, now for the pappardelle. There you go. Leave that in there for about 3 to 5 minutes. It's fresh pappardelle, so let's see how it does. Okay, as you can see, it's boiling nice. Oh, it's getting a little high. We're gonna reduce the heat. Oh, we don't like it too high. See, I'm a one-man cooking machine. You know why? Because I do it with one hand. I'm holding the camera, and I'm cooking at the same time. Well, look at that. Oh, it looks good, eh? Sorry if it's out of focus. No, it's not out of focus. Alright. I hear a cookie. She's a calling. You hear her? She's a barking. She's saying, you got any more carrots down there? I like the carrots. Oh, the carrots in the sauce. No more carrots. Okay. These are almost done. We're gonna let that cook up a little bit. Yeah. A little oregano floating around. I like that, okay? Oh, yeah, a little of pappardelle. 3 minutes. Almost done. Looks like it's done. Okay. So, turn this off. Let's bring this over here. And don't forget to say water bye-bye. Okay, there we go. I like that, eh? Okay. And it's now in the same pot. I'm gonna drizzle some olive oil there. And then we're gonna go back here, add a little olive oil. Right? Just so it doesn't stick. Okay everyone, let's see what's cooking up here. Oh, she's a cooking. She's a cooking. I smell it. Can you smell it? Oh, I smell it. That's good. But you know, we're gonna put a little bit of the Asiago cheese, half of it, in there, like a so. And we're gonna stir it up a little bit. Yeah. We get some good flavor. Good boy. Cookie's still asking for the carrots. You hear her in the background? Boof, boof. Oh yeah, boof, boof. Sometimes we call her boof, boof. She's relentless. But look. Oh, the bolognese is so good. It's a time in our lives, eh? Oh boy. Okay, at this point we want to plate it. So we're going to take it. Oh, the pasta. There's pasta. Looks good, eh? How's that looking? Oh, very nice. A little more pasta. Then what we're gonna do is take a couple of scoops of this. Now I added some of the basil to the sauce. Here we go. Oh, look at that. Okay. Isn't that nice? One more. Oh, yeah. Then we're gonna take some of the basil, like this, you know, like this, and a little bit of the cheese. Let's just add this up there. Oh, the cheese, the cheese, half the cheese. Oh. And there you have it, everyone. How nice is that, eh? It's a very nice cookie. You can stop now. You're not getting any more carrots. All done. So this is the red wine bolognese with a fresh pappardelle. Enjoy everyone. Great. You might like.